Candace Bailey 5. We are coming to you live from the G4 studios in Los Angeles.
We almost got her on Game Center playing iSlash. Almost.
The show started too quickly, but I will try it. I'll try it out. Okay, I'll do it. On the show today, from Spartacus Vengeance, Katrina Law will join us live in the studio. She has the unenviable job of trying to seduce one of the hottest, most nakedest man characters on television. Tough life.
Oh, you know what it's like.
Yeah, do I ever. Just keep the clothes on, please. Oh, Kevin, I'm kidding. I love you.
They know you're kidding. They know what's up.
Then Chris Gore will be here for another round of Buy, Rent, or Pass with a new disc for Tintin and the Three Musketeers and David Newsday.
Plus, if you feel like your job sucks, and you feel like there's nothing you can do about it?
Yes.
You all work for the show. You're not supposed to. That was telling. On today's Loop, we'll talk to Scott Gerber from the Fix Young America movement, which is trying to help solve the epidemic of youth underemployment in America. Big stuff.
Yes.
And Grace Helbig sits down with Will Ferrell, Genesis Rodriguez, and Nick Offerman to hablar en español about their new movie, Casa de mi Padre.
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 I'm sure it won't be strange at all.
Roll those R's. But first, let's welcome some information into our house.
Form of Sarah Underwood.
Yes. Sarah!
Now, we've got our ears to the ground on fresh rumors about the impending arrival of a big screen Apple TV. Plus, Mass Effect 3 fans want a new ending to the game, and they're petitioning BioWare to make it happen. I'll explain later in the feed.
Aww. All right,
thanks, Sarah.
Good, thank you, Sarah. Time now to run down the top five things on the web.
Should we go around the net?
I think we should.
Okay. The time on this program, and we show you someone that's going over a homemade jump, the part where you see them in a wheelchair comes after the stunt.
Yes, right? But not in today's number five item.
Do you have the thing right there? It's gonna follow
the
tie
on the
then? Hill. It'll get
How'd you have the tie over there? There? How'd you have the tie over
the
there?
The first time I did it.
You had it pulled through, so it would
on the right.
Ran up this dude and jumped.
It couldn't have been on the right.
Whatever. It's not worth arguing. What the.
I am constantly asking myself on this show, what was he thinking? What are they always thinking?
They were going to land a sweet trick, bro.
It wasn't even close to that.
You saw all the discussion that happened beforehand. Clearly, they solved it. One of the guys was in head-to-toe orange, and I never noticed it until now. The guy with the camera looked like an escaped convict.
I wouldn't trust him
to plan the physics of a stunt.
You know, I'm not great with grammar, but I'm pretty sure that was a good demonstration of irony.
Ah, that is correct, Candace, actually. That was a fine example of foreshadowed dramatic irony.
Oh, okay.
It's a literary device in which humor arises after the action, based on the audience's presuppositions.
Kevin? Kevin! Wake up! Huh. You bored yourself to sleep with knowledge again. Dumb it down.
Sorry, he fell and broke his face hole. Hurt him. Bad.
You good?
Yep.
You sure? Okay. Today's number four item includes some headlines from our favorite source of fake news, The Onion.
Oh, we love The Onion here, right?
Yeah, we do.
Okay, thanks.
Peacock.
Three people. Yes. In this news blitz, a blighted city takes bold steps to combat crime and uses a lot of electricity in the process.
Our frontline story this hour in Baltimore, the streets have gotten safer thanks to the success of the new permanent daylight initiative, which aims to prevent crime by illuminating the entire city 24 hours a day using over 350,000 high-powered floodlights.
It's just that it's so bright all the time, even in the rain.
City officials say there have been zero violent crimes since the start of the program, except for one man who vandalized the light by throwing his body off a building into it.
Poor guy.
That is exactly why for the last year I've had 26 giant floodlights pointing in every direction in my backyard every single night. Bathe it.
I can't imagine that works.
Oh, it does. Not only has backyard crime fallen dramatically, but now my neighbors, they don't talk to me anymore, and planes are no longer allowed to fly over my house. So that is a win-win-win.
All right, win-win-win. Today's number three item comes to us from one of our favorite web animators, Jason Steele.
That was like a dealer leaving the table. Like,
win,
okay.
Win, win. I mean, you got to do what you got to do.
Yes. She's right. Look, when in Rome, then that Rolling Stone isn't going to gather any birds of a feather in the bush with one hand, let alone two of them.
Can I keep going?
Yeah, go for it. Yeah. Where are we today?
I'm gonna go back to the number three item.
You just did the number three item.
I didn't finish it because people laughed.
Okay.
I got cut off.
Okay, let's see.
Today's number three item comes to us from one of our favorite web animators, Jason Steele from FilmCow.
Finish it up, Bales. Finish it, Bales.
He is responsible for some of the strangest things the internet has ever seen, like llamas with hats and Charlie the Unicorn. His latest imagines Grammy-winning felony assault enthusiast Chris Brown as a superhero.
I want this vault opened, and I want it open now!
Not today, wrongdoer. That vault is staying closed.
It's Chris Brown. We're safe.
I love your music, Chris Brown.
Oh, yeah? Well, you just try and stop me.
With pleasure. Take that.
Stop,
yeah.
Please!
Yeah!
Stop it.
You did it, Chris Brown! You saved the day!
Stop!
Yeah!
Stop it! Please, yeah. Someone help! Yes. Soon the entire city will be mine!
We'll see about that. I'm gonna beat the out of you. You wait and see. Yeah! Yeah!
Help!
Yeah.
Maybe I should do some crime so Chris Brown will fracture my face.
Yeah. Yeah, you're bleeding.
You saved us all, Chris Brown.
Right. And your face.
Chris Brown, Manforce attacking a preschool. We need your help.
Who?
Manforce.
A huge lumbering man, nearly twice your size.
Yeah, I'm gonna sit this one out.
Really makes me wish that the rap wars of the 90s would just flare up one more time. just once.
He's got the most hits of any Grammy winner since Ike Turner.
Oh.
That's true. Oh. You can't keep clapping and walking away. That was mine.
All right, fair enough.
Hey, spring break is here, y'all.
Put things inside of me. What?
Kevin.
I was just going along with the spring. What are we on, number two?
And today's number two is a whoopsie from a place where people are wearing swimsuits, whether they should be or not.
Yes, here's a piece of performance art simply called Pole Dancer Surprise. Stage, everybody, and Charmanity to the VIP lounge.
Oh, give it up, Gavin. Be nice.
I am being nice. Still ahead, Batman's crappiest villain breaks into song.
The Governator gets musical in our number one ATM. Browns.
Make it rain on. You need to work it out? You want to massage? You want to put... No?
No, it was hurting earlier, but I shouldn't have lifted my arm up. I don't know what I did. I think I slept on my arm. Okay. Get out of here. I think I slept on it weird.
Any other knots you need me to work out?
I can't lift it.
Oh, we got a dead arm. Let's get her a sling. Get her a sling. All right. No one moved. Thank you. Great. And at number one today, the triumphant return of YouTuber Lego Lambs.
Lego Lambs is best known for creating impressive musical
that
versions.
Looks weird. We need to give you a pen like McCain.
No, it hurts. I don't want to hold it.
It wasn't McCain. It was
it hurts.
Really?
I'll take.
This is Bob Dole, right? Yeah.
I'll take this.
There we go. Yeah, hold your straw. There we go.
Let me go back.
Okay.
Legoland's is best known for creating impressive musical versions of terrible Arnold Schwarzenegger films.
What happened to you?
I don't know. It hurts really bad, though. I'm trying to stay cool.
All right, we'll get into it. Today, the Arnold's performance, Mr. Freeze, in 1997's truly awful Batman and Robin gets songified.
Batman, you son of a bitch. Find somebody else to harass. Be aware at the reach of my fist, because I'm going to shove it right up your ass. Two queens and a fat little girl are not enough to put a stop to my dream. I am bigger and stronger and smarter than you. I will be the victor, you'll see. So move over, Joker, and go f*** yourself, Penguin. There has never been a villain like me. Batman, you son of a bitch. Can't you see I've already won? Behold, a city of ice. Isn't this nice? The age of me has begun. But this evil doing comes with a hitch. Batman, you son of a guy.
Oh no! Someone should ask Batman which was worse, the murder of his parents or appearing in that movie, because I really feel like
so bad.
They're pretty close to each other.
So
high five.
Bad.
Okay, good. To get your daily viral fix and to check out all the viral videos we have to offer, go to g4tv.com/AroundTheNet. Thank you, Candace.
All right. Grace Helbig met up with Will Ferrell and the rest of the cast of Casa de Mi Padre.
Spoiler alert, Grace is now the head of the third largest cartel south of the Rio Grande.
Hola, mis amigos. Vera, Señor Will Ferrell in the Casa de Mi Padre. Oh, sí.
Soy Armando Álvarez.
Will goes bilingual in a tale as old as time, falling in love with your brother's fiance. But in order to get the girl, he must save his father's ranch from a feared drug lord.
Suelta a la mujer y te dejo vivir.
I was inspired by your film today.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I know. Did you not recognize the lady power suit in front of you?
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
You just need a little neckerchief.
I know.
That's the only thing you're missing.
It's the one thing I'm missing.
But it's the right color scheme.
Thank
and you need white boots.
Yeah, que me sorprende verte vivo, eh?
Quiero a la muchacha.
Voy a conducir esta entrevista en español, ¿bien?
Holy hell, I was not expecting that one.
Hay algo que tienes que saber.
¿Qué es lo que tengo que saber?
Your Spanish was muy bien. Where did you learn how to speak that way?
I learned it at escuela, which means school. It's a little Spanish for you folks.
You speak American?
Huh?
Do you speak American?
No, señor. No habla americano.
You are a really amazing improviser, but how was improvising in Spanish?
It was impossible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I bet.
No, it was all I could do to kind of memorize the scenes in Spanish and to try to pronounce everything as well as I could.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember how to say anything?
Yes.
Okay.
Mi corazón es muy grande.
Something is very big.
My heart.
Oh.
Somos hermanos muy cercanos.
Hombre, pues hemos compartido tantas cosas, ¿eh?
Now, has playing Armando made you a better lover?
It really has.
He's
actually
very passionate.
He's very passionate.
Yeah.
Yes, my love making skills and tactics.
Yeah.
Have increased dramatically.
Really?
Yeah.
What has increased?
Well, I've increased greatly.
Okay. How was the romance with Will?
I would say it's the best thing that's ever happened to me. This was the sweetest, most gentle human being I've ever worked with.
Aww.
And it's a pretty great love scene.
Sería una gran canción. Y la canción sería la verdad.
In this film, a lot was said without words, just with eyes. Can you figure out what I'm saying with my eyes if I do this?
Oh. You know I'm married, right?
Now I do.
You're hoping they didn't mess up your order for the Cobb salad for lunch?
Yeah. That was really impressive.
Yeah.
Brush up on your Espanol, because Casa de mi Padre is one telenovela you'll want to know what the f*** they're saying when you watch it.
Awesome job. Thank you so much, Grace. Are you okay?
Yeah, still ahead, Katrina Law from Spartacus Vengeance will join us live in studio. We guarantee there will be no male nudity.
I don't guarantee that at all. But later, find out how to fix young America. The movement aims to get college grads working again, and you're going to find out about it in The Loop, everybody. So stick around. Listen, if you like half-naked men and lots of blood and violence, you're probably watching MMA and Spartacus.
You are no better than Rascos and the goals, all driven only by your own desires. Do any of us hold worth to you?
The reason I went alone.
A hard comfort. If you had fallen to Glabber's men.
Akron would have let you serve.
We need a leader, not some angry boy who can barely piss without splashing everyone about him.
What would you have me do? Turn from the man that condemned my wife to slavery. Let him live. That took everything from me.
Your heart still beats.
Make out!
You're going to stop! Please welcome Katrina Law, everybody! Let's dive right in, shall we?
Yes, let's
you
do
are,
this.
I mean, Spartacus is supposed to be all that is man, and you just...
Yeah.
You just put him right in his place, left and right.
Well, you know, Mira is a very opinionated slave. She has a lot of opinions going on, and she likes to make them known. So, yeah, she does do a little bit of yelling at Spartacus, but she backs off a little bit every now and then.
Has working, you know, on the set and around all those guys, has that ruined, like, your taste in men? Like, now you're only attracted to the gladiator-esque, totally airbrushed... Not real abs, because that doesn't exist. Well, that, guys don't look like that.
You know, I did grow up on the Jersey Shore, so it's you know, there are a lot of boys that look like
so
that.
So Spartacus with a blowout.
with highlighted tips, yeah.
the frosted tan.
Yeah, it all pretty much goes in line.
So is that now, that's the taste in men then? Is that direction?
No, I actually went for a good old Oklahoma boy who opens doors and says please and thank you. And yes,
opens them by kicking and shouting, right?
I know, because
right?
He's bad.
Yeah, entrance! Oh, that's sweet. That's sweet.
Yeah.
So, I want to talk about the internet fans of this thing, because I am a huge fan as well, and I've dabbled in a form or three and watched as other friends live tweet this thing. And normally, like, I'm sure you get asked all the time about the lack of clothing that happens, and it's
a hot topic.
Yeah. Literally and figuratively, very much so. And you know, there's guys that will write down the time code of when there might be side boob in a movie from the 80s.
Yeah.
I can imagine. Is there only just positive feedbacks and landslides of praise whenever there's a scene?
I wish it were that good. You know, I think for most part it's pretty positive feedback, and most of the fans that watch the show actually really enjoy it for everything that's worth. But we do get a couple of people that seem to just watch it just to complain about it. But I think that's with every show. But yeah, there are a lot of people that want to compare it to porn. But I'm just saying, you know, this must be the best porn you've ever seen in your entire life, because it's production value is pretty good. But that's what I'm saying, the lighting is.
Exactly. So what do you, when you see those responses, do you engage like the fans on Twitter or anything like that, or on forums, or
everybody's entitled to their own opinion, and you know, it's an opinion, so whether or not I choose to engage in the negative or the positive, you know, it's kind of out there for the fans to do, and I'm just doing my job by acting, so.
Well, absolutely. Yeah. Now, was it always a dream growing up to do the acting thing, or did you really want to open up a froyo joint, or?
No, I wanted to be a police officer, and then I wanted to be a cardiologist, and then I wanted to be a shark filmer.
And this was all by the age of three, right?
Yeah, I was very ambitious when I was a child. No, it wasn't until college that I decided to start the acting. I'd never actually acted before then, so.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Were you a tomboy growing up, or?
Very much a tomboy. Yeah. I was usually covered in mud.
Just go outside and roll in it. That was
pretty,
the entire activity.
Pretty much. I ate a lot of bugs when I was a child. I don't know why. It just kind of happened.
It's
I know.
That's natural living. That's good. That made you who you are. Now, were you a strong tomboy growing up, though? Like, in spirit and physically? Or?
Yeah. I was a professional dancer pretty much from the time I was 10 on. I was in a dance company, so I was pretty strong physically. and yeah, it was feisty. My mom had a handful.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Were you, did, were the, professional dancer doesn't sound tomboyish to me, though, unless you were river dancing.
Which, well, I also have a black belt in karate. Does that balance it out?
Okay, yes,
okay,
now we're talking.
There you go, there you go.
Now we're going. What's the black belt in karate?
I got it in taekwondo, but, you know, to be fair, I actually got it because my, I kind of thought my instructor was really cute, so I just got it. I was like, yeah, hell yeah, punch and kick because you're hot.
But all anyway, anakata so. For you, Doug. Was this like at a traditional, like a nice dojo, or was this at a mall next to a Jamba Juice and a Pac Sun?
Yeah, it was Kim's Karate. Okay. Yeah, but you know, I have a black belt, so I did earn it. I did break a board.
Oh, very nice.
There you
That's
go.
Good. So we have board breaking, rolling around in mud, police officer, cardiologist, and at some point, stand-up comedy and an album that you released.
Yes. Yes, I'm in a band called Soundboard Fiction, and we did release an album, and we're coming up to our second album. So,
congrats on that.
Thank
That's
you.
Huge.
So,
I looked up the album on iTunes, and it had a parental advisory sticker on it, and I thought, okay, what's going on
did
here?
Did it?
Yes.
Hmm.
In fact, there was a track that was labeled explicit. It was What's a Girl Gotta Do? and I believe the hook, correct me if I'm wrong, was What's a Girl Gotta Do to Get Laid?
Today.
Today.
Yes.
So... two-parter. One, what's the answer to that? And two, who was this song inspired by? Because clearly this was not written by you about you.
Well, unfortunately, I was kind of going through this really awkward phase of dating in LA where I couldn't get a guy to call me back.
Oh, okay. That was
Yeah. And I was like, oh, come on. I'm not asking for much. Just, you know, a couple little... But anyway, it was a little awkward phase, and I was a little angry and bitter and jaded, and the LA dating thing kind of sucked. So I wrote a song about it to release it, and yeah.
And then a very kind Oklahoma boy opened a door and showed you the way.
Yes, he did.
I love that.
Yes,
well, congrats on that. And good luck on the new album. That's going to be, you've got to come back and play for us.
I could sing it for you, yeah.
Okay, fantastic. Such a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much. Katrina Law, everybody. Spartacus Vengeance airs Friday nights on Starz at 10 p.m. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Such a pleasure. Let's go over to Candace Bailey now.
Thanks, guys. The future is here. Almost. It's time to attack this near future stuff. Goes with my outfit. Look at that, y'all. Is this supposed to hold this up? Oh, I think it is. The future of shaving isn't fewer blades for sensitive skin on your face. It's a longer handle to help shave unsightly hair off your back. The Man Groomer is an electric shaver with an extendable handle for all of that hard-to-reach hair on your backside. It opens up to 130 degrees. That is ridiculous. It has a 1.5-inch blade for an extremely close and smooth shave. That is great news considering razor burn on your back can be a real pain, let me tell ya. You can get your own Man Groomer for only $35. Now, other than manscaping your back, everything in the future will be hands-free. So who needs an umbrella with a worthless handle when you can have a new umbrella? This hands-free umbrella straps onto your shoulders and covers your entire body. Keep warm while the new umbrella protects you from rain, snow, or winds up to 50 miles per hour with a lightweight design that checks in at only 2 pounds. Y'all, this is really cool. I actually really like.
So I was gonna go give our guest a hug goodbye and maybe a photo for Twitter.
Oh, but now you have this.
And they threw the damn new umbrella on my face.
We just are such a mess right now.
Thanks
get
a lot,
out of here.
Show.
For only $45. The new umbrella will shield you from anything Mother Nature throws your way, and you'll only look slightly ridiculous. And finally, are you sick of walking everywhere? Well, you won't have to for very long thanks to Spin Kicks. First seen at this year's CES, these fancy person shoes are battery powered and motorized. Just strap them to your feet and let Spin Kicks do all the hard work. They're controlled by a wireless remote and can reach speeds of up to 10 miles per hour. You can get your very own pair of Spin Kicks for $650. Walking's for poor people. Stick around, we'll learn how to fix. Young America Movement is trying to help you in today's loop right after this. It's time to play leapfrog. So, what happens next? Does she slip and fall on her ass? Does she forget to jump and crashes into the guy? Or does she jump over him and fall on her face? Find out when we return. time to play leapfrog. So, what happens next? Does she slip and fall on her ass? Does she forget to jump and crashes into the guy? Or does she jump over him and fall on her face? It's called leapfrog, not fail frog.
Fail frog!
In case you're just tuning in and wondering why we have a wounded bird on set, Candace Bailey apparently hurt her arm during Around the Net. Somehow, I was really not paying attention. So, let's see it. Yeah. Okay, clapping and, oh, there it was right there.
Oh, that hurt.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Whoa. I think it all started from me doing a little weight moves like this yesterday. I had like 2 pounders, maybe 5 pounders, I don't know. But not enough to strain
You're
my
a delicate
shoulder.
Flower, Candace Bailey.
And then I went to sleep and everything was fine. I woke up and had a really bad pain in my shoulder arm.
The shoulder arm?
Well, where? What is this? Is this my arm or my shoulder?
If your trainer called it a shoulder arm, I would stop taking his tips. no longer take his guidance.
Right there.
All right, you're going to be all right.
It's
okay.
Fine. I just did something that made it kind of pop for a second. But
yeah, you pointed. We saw the. Do we need to show the action replay again?
No, we got all it. We got it.
I want to point out, by the way, the audio wasn't slowed down in the replay. That's exactly how Candace sounds when she hurts herself. All right, well, onward, information soldiers.
Sounds like it's time for Sarah Underwood.
Thanks, guys. Right now, it's time to start the feed.
All the news you need to know.
The feed.
It's Tuesday, March 13th, and here are your top stories. Apple just unveiled an updated Apple TV set-top box, but they're not done yet. That fancy Apple-branded TV we've all been hearing about, aka the iTV, might be going into production soon. On a recent trip overseas, a tech analyst with Jefferies said he was shown, quote, early production evidence of an iTV. He said specialized components for the TV set are already being shipped from Asian suppliers, and full-fledged production should start around May or June, which means Santa could be leaving an iTV under the Christmas tree this year. Yeah! Now, Walmart wants to help put your movies in the cloud so you can watch them anywhere. Sounds cool, right?
Yeah, all right.
Wrong. They want to charge as much as $5 per movie to convert titles that you already own.
What?
Unveiled today, their genius plan says you can bring in any DVD or Blu-ray, and they'll digitally convert the file and upload it to your account on the Vudu Cloud service. The convenience charge, as they're calling it, will be $2 a piece for standard conversions and $5 to up-convert a DVD to fake HD. However, this ripping process is something that anyone can take 5 minutes to learn to do themselves at home for free. But if you're too lazy to do it yourself and have spare cash, you can do that, or you can have Walmart do it for you starting April 16th. If you're feeling a little gypped by the fate of Shepard and his crew at the end of Mass Effect 3, you're not alone, people. Gamers everywhere up in arms over what is being referred to as a cheap, unsatisfying end to the acclaimed trilogy. The Facebook group Demand a Better Ending to Mass Effect 3 has garnered around 21,000 likes. Most are complaining that they don't feel the ending reflects their in-game choices, and a recent poll on BioWare's website shows only 2% of gamers feel satisfied with the series finale, while a whopping 90% are demanding a change. Now, BioWare has yet to comment fully, but has stated that they are aware of the mounting complaints. To follow this story as it develops, head to g4tv.com/me3. And finally, at South by Southwest this week, one marketing agency decided to turn a bunch of homeless people into walking, talking Wi-Fi hotspots. And somehow they didn't think it would backfire. It's called Homeless Hotspots. The idea involved giving 13 volunteers from a homeless shelter mobile Wi-Fi devices and t-shirts that said, "I'm a 4G hotspot." Some found it amusing, and some said it was a good thing because it paid the volunteers $20 for a day's work. But at this point, the clever idea has fully backfired. Most are now criticizing the stunt for exploiting the less fortunate. My guess is someone's getting fired for this one. I'm Sarah Underwood. You've just been fed. Now let's go to Kevin.
Thank you, Sarah Underwood. I love it. This hobo's getting better reception than AT&T with my iPhone. probably true. It's very true. All right, youth employment is at a 60-year low, and little is being done to help future generations survive and thrive in the years to come. Thanks to Fix Young America, it's a campaign that may finally change. Joining me from New York to help us make sense of it all, founder of the Young Entrepreneur Council, Scott Gerber is here, everybody. So, Scott, let's hop into this. I know Young America is, literally broke, but you say the whole system is figuratively broke as well. Is that the case?
Absolutely. I mean, let's look at the facts, Kevin. I mean, the bottom line is 18 to 24-year-olds, there's only 54% of us that are actually working right now. That is a disaster. And if we don't fix something soon, we're going to see an entire generation become lost, sucking, basically screwed by debt. I mean, debt right now in $1 trillion for college student loan debt. And let's not, of course, forget that when this generation gets older, these are supposed to be the business owners and leaders of tomorrow. How are they going to do that if they're bankrupt? This is the time to make change happen.
So, Scott, is that because the system is flawed and against them, or is that because the 20,000 of them are on Facebook right now demanding a better ending to Mass Effect?
Well, I certainly think there needs to be a big change on all levels. I mean, first and foremost, we need to change a lot that the Gen Y culture is known for, mainly that sort of lazy mentality and all that sort of stuff that entitlement nature comes with. But there's certainly the cards are stacked against them. There's no question. I mean, right now, you have them going into college right now to get a degree that, frankly, in most cases, doesn't equate to anything. You have more college graduates now unemployed than in the recent memory, 60-year low, as you said earlier. So you have a lot of things that are needing to be changed, more of a cultural shift, a total paradigm shift across the boards, so that we can make this a more entrepreneurial, free agent kind of culture.
Right. Well, those sound like pretty massive undertakings. How is Fix Young America going to help that?
Well, first and foremost, we got to change the discourse. Right now in mainstream media, all you keep hearing about is lost generation, we're screwed, who's to blame. The fact of the matter is there are solutions working right now all across America, in academia, the government, the private sector, nonprofits. The problem is nobody's talking about them. But there's a lot of things out there right now we can copy and paste, take from hyperlocals to hyperlocal level to national or regionally, and start finding ways to make each of these different sectors better. We just need to know about it. So Fix Young America went out there, found all these solutions to start that conversation and take the next step in what Occupy Wall Street did, which is build up that frustration, and now let's try to change it into tangible action.
All right, Scott, let's talk solutions then. You cobbled together all these proposed solutions. Are you going to keep them in a lockbox and then sell them for $9.95 a month? Or how does this work? Like the Jobs Act, for example, that passed in the House last week. Is that something that's like the first step towards achieving these goals?
Absolutely. It's one of the solutions that we're very much behind. You know, there's a big part of the Jobs Act is the crowdfunding bill, which will allow non-accredited investors to be able to give money towards startup capital fundraises. Huge game changer in the startup space. It was put forth by Eric Cantor and before that, Congressman McHenry, who's an FYA supporter. And basically, this is one of the many policy changes on the Hill that can fully, change the landscape of startups, give access to capital to entrepreneurs, very, very big deal. So we're certainly not going to put it in a lockbox. This is one of the ideas that ultimately we're going to put out there to the masses. And what we've done is basically create this book called Fix Young America, same name, and we're going to put it out this May, right around graduation season. But we need everybody's help because it's part of a larger campaign to get these solutions out there. We have a campaign going on Indiegogo.com. And the more money we raise, the more we're going to put this book in the hands of every decision maker across America, from academia to the government, so that we can actually change the discourse, have a real conversation, and hold people accountable for this information as we keep pushing new solutions out there.
Scott, what about the viewers at home that are sitting there going, okay, but I'm going to college right now, I've got mounting student loan debt, I'm absolutely totally screwed. Are they screwed? Are they going to see some relief for their student loan debt?
Well, student loan debt, huge issue, will be a huge, huge issue in the presidential election, no question. First and foremost, definitely check out the income-based repayment, better known as the student startup plan. This is something that can help you to ease your college student loan debt up to 10% of your discretionary income when you graduate, have a little bit of easing of that so you can use money to start a business or as you go and try to find employment. But also, while you're thinking about college or about to go there, make sure you're getting a practical education alongside that liberal arts degree. I got to tell you, if you are going to a vocational school and learning how to become, let's say, a mechanic, but you don't know how to run an auto body shop, that's a huge problem. Same thing if you're going to go and learn English, but you're not going to go learn how to have a tutoring service or something that's going to actually be able to place you into a job of your own creation in case you can't find that traditional job.
Well, Scott, it's a huge undertaking. I know you have a giant campaign ahead of you. I know you're just getting started as well. So I want to thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us about it. Scott Gerber, everybody, for keeping For keeping up with him and everything else, go to Indiegogo.com and find out how you can help contribute to Fix Young America. Thank you again, sir. Now let's go over to Candace and Sarah.
G4's hit show Bomb Patrol Afghanistan is back with newly uncovered footage that gets you closer to the action.
Yeah, all new episodes start March 27th, and to celebrate, G4 is giving away iRobot Roombas.
Yes.
Head to Facebook.com/Bomb Patrol to find out why.
Stick around if you want to see Chris Gore take on the Three Musketeers and Tintin in DVD set. That's up next.
The Feed is brought to you by Dr. Pepper 10. It's not for women. Do you want to get things done and do it with the ease of a pinch and a swipe? Well, then you want to check out Clear for the iPhone. Clear is simply a list maker app, but it's not your average to-do list based on checking off boxes. Clear takes full advantage of the gestures on iOS in building a cascading collection of limitless lists that are easy on the eyes. To create an item on an empty list, you simply tap the screen. Once you've built a long list, you then create items by pulling down or pulling apart items with your fingers. To complete a task, swipe it to the right. To delete it, swipe it to the left. There are three levels in Clear: the main menu, your lists collection, and your lists themselves. Whenever you need to access a higher menu, you simply pinch your fingers. It's the next step in gesture-based applications, so get stuff done and do it with ease for only $2. Tomorrow on Attack of the Show.
Community's Jim Rash will school us about playing Dean Pelton and how he won an Oscar. Then Matt Myra gets his hands on the super thin 4G LTE Droid Razer Max on Gadgetron. And Chris Gore goes undercover with Jonah Hill, Channing Tatum, and Ice Cube for 21 Jump Street.
It's Attack of the Show tomorrow at 7.
DVDs, you have to grow up fast because it's already DVD Tuesday. Welcome back, film expert Chris Gore. How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Good.
It's a good thing you didn't fall. I know what that's like. Oh. I know what it's like to fall. Watch it.
What's up first?
First, we have The Adventures of Tintin.
Now, considering this is based on a European comic strip most people in the U.S. never even heard of, a lot of big people worked on this film.
Oh, my God, it's great. Like, Edgar Wright worked on the script, Simon Pegg and Nick Frost, they play these two cops in it, Steven Spielberg, kind of a name that you know,
yeah,
Peter
I think
Jackson.
I've heard of him.
Yeah, big names, but you don't have to know about the comic to enjoy it. What this really is, it's almost like an animated Indiana Jones movie. The action is awesome, over the top. It's definitely better than that last Indiana Jones film. And Andy Serkis is amazing as this drunken sea captain. He is so funny in it, but I think a lot of people were turned off by the fact that they just didn't know these characters. I mean, it's not like Tintin is as popular as, say, a Batman or an Iron Man, you know?
Uh-huh.
So it's too bad, because the movie's awesome. It's a lot of fun.
This is a silly question, but is Tintin the boy or the dog?
Tintin's the boy.
Okay.
Yes. But the dog is awesome. The dog is super.
And I just saw the dog running around.
So cute. You would love the dog.
Oh, I would love the dog. What's the bottom line, Chris?
Bottom line is rent it.
Okay.
Really worthwhile.
All right. I'm going to rent it. What's our next DVD?
Young Adult.
Now, Jason Reitman and Diablo Cody, who made Juno, reteamed for this comedy. What did you think?
One of my favorite films of last year, robbed at the Oscars. Charlize Theron is amazing as this 37-year-old woman who kind of goes back and sees her back home to see her college sweetheart and win his love back, even though he's married and has a kid.
She's a hot mess, right?
It's sort of like, and then she meets Patton Oswalt, who's this guy who was, he was disfigured in high school. I won't tell you exactly what happened, but it's like he's disfigured on the outside. She's emotionally disfigured. It's a romantic comedy. That's what it is.
I think you told us what happens.
The thing is, yes, well, they become friends. It's a romantic comedy, but I think that they made a mistake. They marketed this as this sort of like, you know, highbrow, you know, subtle comedy. And yes, it's that. They should have marketed it just like a Jennifer Aniston, one of those crappy comedies that I never care about. Market it like that so more people would see it. Patton Oswalt is amazing in it. He's so good.
All right, what's the bottom line?
Bottom line is buy it.
And yes!
A great commentary by Jason Reitman as well.
All right, okay.
One of the best movies of last year.
Nice. What else do you have to check out?
The Three Musketeers.
Now, how is this latest adaptation of the story of the Three Musketeers?
It's okay. It's okay.
It looked like it was going to be really good.
It looks fun, and yes, there's fun, but I think it sort of toes the line between is like, is this for 9-year-olds or this is for adults? Aww. Like, I mean, you've got some nice cleavage. Let's be honest. There's cleavage.
Let's be honest.
There's swords, but I really feel like it, in terms of tone, it didn't know if it wanted to be for kids or for adults.
Okay.
I mean, you can do both in a movie, but I feel like the action. Also, some of the stuff looks kind of cheap and rushed.
Okay.
It was just very ambitious. Maybe they bit off a little more than they could chew for this adaptation.
All right, bottom line?
Bottom line is pass, I'm sorry to say.
Pass.
I was almost towards a red, though. It could be fun.
Okay, maybe I could check it out.
You can drunk stream it. I've done that a million times.
Okay, done.
A lot of times I do that.
Now we've got time for one more DVD.
Okay, cool. But before we get to that, I had a horrible family tragedy you might have heard about this weekend.
What?
Well, I had to see this movie, and it was the worst thing that's happened to me this year. It was horrible.
Jack and Jill. I used to love Adam Sandler movies. What happened?
We all used to love him. I don't know what happened. Al Pacino's in this. You've got an Oscar winner.
What?
Al Pacino ruins his career. You've got Adam Sandler. He's not funny.
I mean, Jack and Jill.
You could take 15 seconds of any episode of 30 Rock. There are more laughs in 15 seconds of 30 Rock than this entire film. Oh. I think it has a 3% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. And I watch the extras.
Oh. What is wrong with you?
I watch the extras on this. So when I say I suffered a family tragedy, I suffered a family tragedy.
You
did. I saw Jack and Jill.
You did.
Attack of the show.
I don't even
know. What am I doing?
I don't even know why I'm going to ask this, but what's the bottom line?
Pass.
Okay.
I mean, he broke your arm, but I had to watch Jack and Jill.
Okay, I'm sorry, Chris. Thanks, Chris.
Thank you.
So we'll both be at WonderCon this weekend.
That's right. I'm going to be at WonderCon this weekend. I got a panel on Saturday called Wild Cartoon Kingdom.
Nice.
Come check out the footage from my new show, Fetishville. It's going to be a lot of fun. Then we're all going out drinking in Anaheim.
Yeah!
Whatever the best bar is in.
It's time for today's epic fail.
Yes, here's a young daredevil mixing fire and ice. And warning, do not try this at home.
Epic fail!
Is your whole office united?
Did what?
He made it into the burn unit and the frostbite ward at the same time!
To be fair, that guy is probably not wearing a sling right now.
I can lift the other arm!
Hey, that's a nice celebration. Hey. It's thank you time, everybody. You know how this works. We're gonna thank Scott Gerber.
Yeah.
We're gonna thank Chris Gore. We're gonna thank Grace Helbig, and of course, to thank Katrina Law.
Yes, we are.
And we're also going to thank Adam Sandler for Jack and Jill, one of the most underrated comedies
of our
generation.
I love him. What happened?
Loved him.
I still love him.
Happy Gilmore.
I know.
Billy Madison.
I know.
Yeah.
Good night, y'all.
Was there others?
Yes.
There was a couple others in there.
Yes,
what was
Spanglish.
That?
He was awesome in Spanglish. And he played a totally different character. Good night.